I just wanted to talk a little bit about the Tefsel mil-spec wire that we use for making the loom in Nigel's ute. Now, most of the automotive wire that you'd be used to seeing is pretty cheap and it'll get the job done. There are some pretty big advantages with the Tefsel wire though, and I wanted to explain those. Now, first of all, you'll notice if you compare length of Tefsel wire with some regular automotive wire, you can notice that the insulation on the outside of the Tefsel is much, much thinner. Now, this really helps when you're running a lot of wiring through a loom because the bunch of wire is much smaller in diameter. It's also a hell of a lot lighter. Now, wire on its own, you might not think it weighs very much, but when you've got quite a complicated loom, that weight really starts to add up. Despite the insulation being so much thinner, it actually offers more protection and safety to the wire than what you'd get from regular automotive wiring. Now, I want to show you one of the advantages, which is its heat resistance. So what we're going to do here is we're going to heat up a length of regular automotive wire alongside a piece of Tefsel. What you can see is with the heat gun on this wire, the Tefsel wire basically doesn't discolor, it doesn't get damaged at all. It still remains just the same as before the test. The normal automotive hookup wire, on the other hand, you can see the insulation rapidly discolors, then actually burns. Now, where it's burnt like that, it'll crumble, it'll pull off the wire itself, exposing the copper strands underneath, and that's a great chance for that wire to short out and cause a lot of damage. So the Tefsel wire is much more resistant to heat, it's much more resistant to abrasion as well, and that's going to end up giving you a much more reliable loom. That's exactly what you need in the rough sort of motorsport world. You want to be able to rely on your wiring loom.
For online tuning courses, visit learntotune.com.